Hey everybody, what's going on? Star here, and this is story time. I've done a couple of these videos. If you're interested in what they are, I recommend go checking out the old ones. I have a playlist of these, but I have not really been keeping up with this at all. It's pretty much, if you're unfamiliar with it, which a lot of you probably are, it's kind of like a vlog, except instead of seeing some nerd talk to you, you are seeing stuff that I have drawn. And in this particular video, you are watching me draw a female scout. Don't know why, it comes out alright. There's a couple things I'm unhappy about with it, but I never went back to really fix the things I told myself that I would. If you actually go and watch the last story time, I also say I have not been keeping up with these, because it is definitely true. Sometimes it's just hard to think about what to talk about, or I really don't feel like recording what I'm drawing or anything like that, but whatever. In a few hours, I'm going to be going to Boston, and I thought I would mention that. To say I'm not going to be around for a few days, I'll be back around the 9th. I do have a bunch of videos that are recorded in preparation to say, you know what, I want to upload videos even while I'm gone because I'm like that. So I still should be uploading a couple of things. A lot of tribes lately, not a lot of Team Fortress. I'm not quitting Team Fortress by any means. Tribes is a lot of fun. It's kind of a nice casual game to jump into for myself and just derp around and mess around, not take entirely that seriously. And a lot of questions have been asked about even when I would quit Team Fortress, and I don't know. It's still a lot of fun to me, and there's still a lot of stuff I wish to be doing in it. I don't see any time in the foreseeable future that I would honestly just completely drop Team Fortress altogether. So that's not going to be happening anytime soon. And I think even in one of the Answer Times videos, somebody asked, like, if I had kids and a wife and a house, and I was all, you know, set up and old and into responsible things, would I still be playing Team Fortress? Probably. Those things aren't really going to affect what I'm doing. To a certain extent. Probably. I don't know. But really that question more so leads to what is going to happen to Team Fortress in the future, where is it going to go, and I don't know. But what we're actually going to talk about for this video while you watch me draw or space out and do something else is some stories about in the past when I've gone to Boston. There's one in particular which I'm even going to try and fit some pictures in here of when I went there. Usually I go there by train. I've mentioned this a couple times. It takes a long ass time to get there. My brother lives in Boston as well as my girlfriend, Mr. Sexy, so I get to see them both. Usually not so much my brother, but the first time I went down there, we linked up and decided we were going to go to this gun shooting range, which I had never been to one before. And he was like, yo, you should totally go to one of these things. You get to shoot things. They go boom. And I was like, you know what? That does sound pretty cool and extremely expensive. I'm really cheap, but let's go anyway. So we went down there. The first funny part about it was that we drove to New Hampshire, and it's a gun shooting range, and it's on Gay Street. So we finally get there. We go down Gay Street to find this place. And of course, the place moved a street away, and I can only assume they moved the location of this building is because it was on Gay Street. That's the only conclusion I can come up to. It's like a block away from where it used to be, but it's not Gay Street anymore, so it's okay. That's cool. And we get in there, and I've actually got a whole bunch of pictures of what's in there, and just guns, every gun you could think of across the entire wall. Like, gigantic miniguns and everything. A lot of the stuff I don't even think I have pictures of. Pretty crazy stuff. It was really cool to see. I shot a .22 pistol, which was like, nah, it's alright, it's a pistol, it's kinda cool. And then we go up to the guy, and I was telling my brother I really wanted to shoot. They have all those guns, a lot of them you can buy, but not all of them you can, like, test shoot in the range that they have. And I see an M14 on the wall, and I'm like, wow, M14? That's one of the coolest guns ever. I would like to shoot that. So we tell the guy, hey, can we use the M14? And it was kind of funny because he just gives us this blank stare and kind of douchey and says, we don't have an M14. And he just stares back at us. There's like this big awkward silence where we're just both, I look at my brother and he doesn't really know the name of it, so he's kind of counting on me to know what it is. And we just look at each other for a moment and he's staring at us. Yeah, there's no M14. And I'm like, well, what is that on the wall over there? And he goes, oh, that's a M41A, or whatever it's called, M14A, I think that's the name of it. And I'm like, oh, okay, well, can we shoot that? I don't know, it was like the douchiest awkward silence ever. And the thing is, if you actually go on the Wikipedia and, like, search for the differences between an M14 an M4-1A, or whatever it's called. I don't even remember. Just despite this guy, I'm going to be calling it an M14 forever. It will tell you that there is almost no difference. It is really, really difficult. You have to be, like, super expert to even tell. Which is cool. I mean, I don't mind that he tried to tell us that it wasn't actually an M14, but it was so awkward because he didn't say anything. He just said, we don't have one of those, and just stared at us like, don't you know that, you freaking scrubs? Give me a break. So disrespectful. So I got to shot that. That was really cool. It was pretty awesome. Cool experience to actually get hands on a gun. I've been playing first person shooters for all my life, and to actually fire one and be like, oh, that's what one of those things are. You don't left click the mouse to shoot this. There's actually like a trigger and a whole bunch of moving parts. Phenomenal. And actually, I just double checked. I knew what I was saying was wrong. It was just, I think, an M1A rifle. And I don't know, he should have said something. Obviously, I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm no gun expert. So just explain it to me, Mr. Gun Shop Dude. Come on. Not much really goes on when I go to Boston. That's about the most interesting story I have right now, other than the one I already told where that lady thought I was homeless, and that was pretty funny, but I already told that one. Other than that, I really just eat a lot of awesome food, and there was that one time we went to an aquarium, there was an octopus, I made contact with the octopus, we communicated a little bit, he said, eh, not a big deal being in an aquarium, he doesn't mind, he gets to sleep all day, and then he came up to the glass and showed me his butt. So that's really all that has really happened there. I'm going to deviate and want to one more story, because I don't want this video to be this short. It's only about 6 minutes so far. Traditionally, these are a bit longer, and this one is actually somewhat related, where I went paintballing with my brother once. I have, in fact, done that. He has always tried to convince me to do things that are things I normally wouldn't do. He is constantly, every time I talk to him, he tries to get me to go kayaking, and I'm like, wow, that sounds like there's going to be a computer near that. Maybe I should not go ahead and do that. So we did go paintballing once. It was kind of cool. The experience itself probably could have went a lot better. It was an indoor place. I think it was even raining outside, so nice that it was indoors, but it was pretty bad. I mean, for the first paintball experience ever, it kind of sucked. But I know that's because of a couple things. For one, the ground was so slippery from how much paint there was. Like, if you didn't have cleats and you tried to run around, you would just slip, fall, bust your ass, and be like, you know what, I'm done, don't shoot me, I'm done, I already fell and humiliated myself, I think I twisted my ankle, please stop shooting me. And that's the second thing, the people we were playing against, like the other people that were there, had done this a whole bunch of times before. Like, they had paintball and uniform, super serious, and they didn't like us playing because we were kind of just like, you know, whatever, let's go play paintball, it'll be fun, we're in regular t-shirts, we don't get that hardcore into this. So I think they wanted us to stop playing. So kind of usually when they shoot you, you put your hands up in the air and you walk off the field, and they stop shooting you unless they're douchebags, which they were, and they continued to shoot despite the fact that, oh hey, he's obviously getting out of here, let's shoot him a few more times. But despite that, it was fun. I ain't no bitch. It didn't really hurt that much. Compared to, actually, no, there was another paintball experience that I had that I completely forgot, probably blacked out of my memory. One of my friends, a long time ago, had a paintball gun. And I did not have a paintball gun, but for some reason we still played paintball, and it was more like manhunt in the woods. I'm going to hunt you down and shoot you. It'll be fun. And I have to be honest, to a certain extent, it kind of was fun, just sort of playing like Mission Impossible, super stealth, spy, I'm hiding from you, I don't want to get shot. And I, like, buried myself under a bunch of leaves, and somebody walked completely, like, almost on top of me, didn't notice me, so it was pretty funny. Then I finally left the forest, people realized I left, shot me point blank with it, and that's the end of the story. That was not fun, that kind of hurt. Normal paintballing is not a big deal. So, that was kind of fun. But that's really all the story I've got. There's a lot of ones that I could tell, and I'm sorry for not keeping up with these and for cutting it a little bit short here. There is a bunch of stuff I could talk about, but I'd rather have them in their own video, and I kind of have to be in the mood to talk about them. I have a few things in mind, like the one time I went to a mental institution and spent some time there. That already sounds like an amazing story, and trust me, it is an amazing story. Just need to be in the mood to tell it. I will get to it eventually. It's kind of ridiculous, kind of funny. but I'll catch you guys later. I hope you can look forward to that, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, drop some like buttons on it, and I will see you guys next time.